Hey everyone, welcome back to IELTS.NishaGarg. This is a speaking sample video. Speaking test contains three parts: part 1, introductory question, part 2, cue card, and part 3 are follow-up questions. I'm commencing with part 1, which contains four basic questions. Hi.
Hello.
May I know your full name?
My name is Robin Lola.
How may I address you?
You may call me Robin.
Can I see your ID?
Yes.
Where are you from?
I'm from city Chandigarh. It is the joint capital of both Haryana and Punjab state. With a population of around 2 million people, it is a bustling, energetic city which is thriving on recent developments in IT sector as well as educational aspects.
Have you ever been to museum to learn history?
Well, I've never been to any museum to learn history because I never liked history. I was a science student. I liked mathematics most. But yes, I was never a big fan of history.
Do you think history is important?
Yes, I do believe history is important. And there are various histories. Like if you talk about the ancient histories, yes, I'm much more interested in that rather than the recent histories because I never liked the World War part. So the ancient history, which includes Greeks, Romans, and the gods, yes, that fancies me.
Do you like dessert?
Yes, I love eating dessert. That's the best thing which we humans have after dinner. So that is the best thing. And there is a very local, you know, dessert which my mom cooks for me. And we call it carrots where they are now in India. So I love that after dinner.
Have you ever made a cake?
Well, I was a very bright student in studies, but I was not active in other activities if we talk about like baking or, you know, the other curriculum activities. So I was never very good at it, so I didn't fancy that.
Do you often like to listen to music?
Yes, I love listening to music. That is part and parcel of everybody's life. Whenever I feel low, it gives me energy. Whenever I go to gym, you know, I like doing that because it gives a different kind of a motivation.
Have you ever been to a concert?
Yes, not recently though, but I have been to a few concerts when I was in my college during my graduation day. So they organized a band. So that was a very good concert because that was the very first time when I attended that. It was a good experience to learn different various kind of cultures as well as different musical aspects. So it was fun to be a part.
Have you ever learned to play a musical instrument?
Well, I never got a chance to do that because the area from where I belong to, we were very much focused on studies, so that was not being asked to do any extracurricular activities. Even in the free time, we used to play a lot of cricket and football, but we never, you know, tried that, playing any instrument, musical song.
What languages do you speak?
Yeah, I can speak fluently a couple of languages. Yes, Hindi, which is our mother tongue, and apart from that, I'm very good at English. So, and there are a few dialects, you know, which are associated with my regional boundaries, so I'm good at those as well.
So that was the part 1. Now we are heading towards part 2, that is cue card. Describe a crowded place you have visited. Where is it? When you went there? With whom you went there? And explain how you felt about being there. So examiner will give you this cue card and will provide you 1 minute to organize the ideas. Paper and pen will also be given to you in case you want to jot down something. Here is your 1 minute. Shall we start?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. For the 2 minutes consistently, you have to speak on this topic covering these bullet points.
Shall we?
Yeah, start.
Yeah, so I've never been a fan of visiting crowded places though I enjoy my quality, but I would like to mention one particular scenario where I went to a crowded place recently. So it happened last week. It was December the 25th, and I went to a concert that was organized on Sukhna Lake. It's in Chandigarh. So yes, I did go for that event, and the event was about food and recipes. So it it was kind of a very global kind of a concert because there was variety of cuisines available over there. So there were people from all over the continents. There were Mexican people, there were American people. So they were representing different kind of the food items which are quite popular in their region. So that included pizzas, pastries, and even avocado chats and all those things. So I went there with my little brother, with my younger one. So his name is Sai. Actually, he is a foodie fellow. So he never wanted to miss the chance to go there. So whenever we got the invitation, so we went there. So it was actually Saturday evening. So we never wanted to miss that on particular because that was coming on weekend. So we had ample time for that. And it was a good feeling, and I must call it amazing feeling indeed because we got to taste a lot of things over there. We got to know a lot about different cultures. Actually, there was different seminars over there where they were explaining the food history, like how did it invented from Egypt to the modern Europe. So we got to learn a lot about these people. There was little, like, you know, the chat shows were available over there, so we did participate in that, and we got to know a lot about like people. And there was one particular arrangement there, so where we were like there was like open mic kind of a stage which was available, so we just needed to speak like what do you like about Tan food. And it was really, you know, funny, and it was really an excitement to get to know a lot about what people's opinion, because people were discussing like how they feel about Indian food and all. So we did participate in that. It was overall a very good experience.
Nice. Now we are heading towards part 3, that is follow-up questions. Please be descriptive in your answer and incorporate example where it is relevant. Is there a completely quiet place in your hometown?
Well, I believe there are many quiet places in my hometown because it is not a very crowded city. So there are few places, and among those, there is a place, you know, it's the backside of the Sukhna Lake which I like the most. So that is a quiet place which I like. I often go there for, you know, running or even spending some time whenever I feel like I can something.
Do you like to go to the places where there are many people?
Well, that is not my cup of tea because I like my own country much more than that. And that because down to my previous experience, because there are few times when I like to go to crowded place like Random Hall or whenever there is a concert kind of a thing. But most of the time, if given a chance, I would definitely avoid that situation.
Do you like the places with large space?
Well, that has divided opinion because, you know, that depends upon if I'm going for any outdoor activity. Suppose I need to play a football match or any sports activities is going to happen, then I would definitely fancy that kind of a place. And on the other hand, saying if there is a place where I want to sit alone and I want to focus on myself, so yeah, I wouldn't want that place to be a large place.
What do you think is the most important thing of a public event?
Well, there are, you know, there are multitudinous things which we can, which are very
important,
which are very important. And to name a few, like I would mention security as one of the, you know, the most important thing which we should take care of, because public security is one of the best thing which we can look forward to, because without security it is not going to be possible. And apart from that, you know, the kind of handling what a public event should be having and the kind of people they are involving, so there are multiple things here.
What kind of places do people want to go when they want to be alone?
That depends upon person to person, because everybody has got a different taste of things. I have met a few friends who prefer solo traveling, so they like that kind of a company. There are few people who like to sit inside their home watching TV, like they enjoy their own company. So that depends, that they has got a better opinion. And on the contrary, my younger brother, so he likes, you know, going to library to sit in a quiet place.
What are the types of problems that can be better solved by group work?
Well, there are numerous things which can be better solved by teamwork, because just for an example, if you are going to be assigned with a different kind of assignment and it becomes a time challenging thing, because time can be a huge constraint in that particular process. So by teamwork you can help each other, And so it will be much better to manage time, and it will give you the future references that you can get a lot to learn from that. That could be very handy in the near future.
Nice. So that was the speaking video. The only tip to fetch 7 band or 8 band, 8.5, 9 bands in speaking is just be yourself, be confident. Do not get scared if examiner asks you many questions. If examiner asks you multiple questions, it means he or she is taking interest in your speaking. Just display yourself very confidently, incorporate examples where it is relevant, and all the best for the exam. Thank you for watching the full video. Kindly subscribe and share.